as y'all know how 2020 has been with all the police brutality and all that other stuff like that, the Black Lives Matter movement and all that type of stuff like that. Us as melanin folk, I don't really use the term African-American no more, but that's a story for a different day. But us melanin folk, you know, we have a different approach when it comes to dealing with police. And it's not something that just happens from experience sometimes, something that's developed out of habit. It's more like the generation before you says, hey, you should do this, do this, do this. They call it the talk. So the question is, I know L Boogie is still little, but even for Simone, because it applies to females too.
Yes, it does.
Are you planning on having that talk with yours, or have you done it already?
I haven't done it yet. I am going to at some point in time. I mean, we've just really introduced the concept maybe a few years back of there are people that don't like you because of the color of your skin. And that's a heavy topic to break down to. I think she was five at the time, maybe, to a five-year-old, because I think we were reading a book or something. And we were explaining some of that kind of stuff to her. So I think we'll gradually work her into it and kind of explain to her, because we don't watch the news in the house at all. So she wouldn't see all of the reports and stuff. So she wouldn't have caught it, you know, indirectly like that. So
yeah, that should have had you panicking, mad, all that, man. That's negative energy in the house when you watch the news. No problem. You know, anybody watch the news, y'all do your thing. But
yeah, no, I know what's going on, but you don't have to watch the news all day, every day.
Yeah.
So yes, I plan on having the talk with both of my little ones at some point in time in their lives. So you have older children. Have you had the talk with yours?
Yeah, I have. Actually, a couple times. It's basically, you know, more Kevondre, because he's out and about like that. You know what I'm saying? But I have had that talk, you know what I mean? If you run into a cop, just keep your hands at your 10 and 2. Make sure you already got your license and your whole wallet or whatever on the dashboard. Just yes or no, and leave it at that. Don't be firing back off at them. Don't reach for nothing. No sudden movements. Nothing like that. Because, you know, it could really happen. Mm-hmm. And Kevondre actually had a situation a couple months ago where they were at the basketball court. Something happened with some other boy that was out at the basketball court. He allegedly called the police. Police showed up, and they're asking these minors for their IDs and what's your name, where you stay. You know, shit, they really not supposed to ask a minor without a parent. They're not. Unless they're really committing a freaking crime, then they can do it.
Right, sure.
But, and then, you know, he told them little boys, my son included, that I'll slap y'all in y'all mouth to something to that effect.
Mm-hmm.
And I explained to him that's one of the very same situations. And he was a white cop.
How old is Dre now?
Dre is 15. He'll actually be 16 this month.
Yeah. Okay. By the time I had my first one of those experiences. So yeah.
Yeah. Same year. I was about 15, 16. And we stayed on Morgan Road. Mm-hmm. I remember I was coming home from church.
Mm-hmm.
And Officer Florida, if anybody in Augusta remember Officer Florida, he was a bitch. Excuse my French. You know, he stopped us because they got a call to somebody was fighting somewhere. So they stopped us and asked me for my ID and where you coming from. I said, I'm coming from church. He going to laugh. Y'all don't go to church. And I'm like, y'all. But you know, I left it at that. You know what I'm saying? Mm. He gave my ID back. He went on about his business. And I'm gonna say all cops is not like that. And that's part of the talk that I have. I know everybody probably doesn't. They're different variations of it. But I still let them know that every cop is not like that. You're gonna have that pocket of cops that are bigots and all that other stuff. But a lot of them cats are some stand-up citizens, man. I done been pulled over quite a few times in uniform, not in uniform. And you know what I'm saying? As long as you just gotcha, officer. Yeah, you got me. I was speeding. Cool. All right. You gonna give me the ticket?
Yeah.
And a lot of times they'll let you off. They'll let you off. They'll be like, you know what, you being cool?
Yeah.
I'm cool. Take off. You know what I'm saying? And I do a lot of career days and stuff before COVID at Keontae School. So you know what I'm saying? There's cops there, and we just all shooting the stuff. They keep trying to get me to join. when I get out the army. I ain't finna be no cop. I tried it once, failed a lot of tech tests. I'm good.
You probably still failed a lot of tests.
Yeah, I probably would. Hey, the dude was good, man. The dude was good. They didn't even put me on a machine yet, man. He was just, are you sure? Once we get started, he first 48'd me, bro.
You in there sweating and crying and shit. Yeah, you ain't even done nothing.
He first 48'd me. I had my hands in my sleeves and shit. Look, mm-hmm. Okay, so this is what happened. It was a mm-hmm. Thursday. I wasn't even there. But they had told. But back to the conversation. But yeah, the talk, I think, is very important for our, mm-hmm. especially our generation, teaching it to the younger generation. Because them some fucking firecrackers, boy, they will pop the hell off mm-hmm. at the drop of a dime, man. I mean, over the smallest fucking things. There was a shooting at the little Stars and Stripes place in Augusta over over a Black and Mild, bro. A fucking Black and Mild.
Damn, I'll buy you some Black and Mild. Somebody's life ain't.
And I guarantee it probably wasn't a whole pack because he said he was outside smoking and then when he came back out, it was gone. So you fighting, you getting all that shit about half a Black and Mild. And it was 11 of them little Thundercat firecrackers and one grown ass man with his family. So the grown ass man did what he had to do, man. He let off some shots. And I don't blame him at all for that. But
you with your family, yeah.
Yeah, you gotta protect yours, man. I mean, he had like a 13-year-old. His mom was there, his grandmama was there.
Oh man, yeah.
He had this 12-year-old autistic son, like a 4-year-old. Yeah, you're gonna let mm-hmm. off some shots. But the talk is extremely important. I hope one day we'll see what this administration that's coming in does. But I hope one day this talk will no longer be necessary because I mean, yeah, they're there to protect and serve. If somebody breaking my house, yeah, and I'm not mm-hmm. home, I'm calling the police. If I am home, I'll tell the police to bring the coroner. But that's neither here nor there.
Right.
Yeah, I'm not going to. Somebody's breaking in my house. Yeah, it's a body in my kitchen, man. Y'all might want to come get this shit.
Actually, you're supposed to say, I feared for my life.
Oh, yeah.
And that way you're good.
I was scared. And
yes.
But yeah, I mean, it's serious business out here, man. Because a lot of them cops is, excuse my French, no foul language, dickheads.
It's complete, a power trip.
Yeah, complete dickheads. They probably got mm-hmm. bullied in school or some shit like that, and they get mm-hmm. this little bit of power. And our demographic can be a little intimidating sometimes. Just our presence is intimidating a lot of times. So them same cats that be intimidated, not in their little uniform, put on their uniform like they fucking Superman. Yeah, the talk.
Yeah,
definitely had the talk.
For me to go back a little bit, I think my first experience, and I don't even think I had the talk yet, was 14. We were staying, that had to be Hillis Road.
Yeah, 14. Yeah, we're staying in Georgetown. Yeah. So shout out staying, Georgetown, them ye boys out there.
So we were outside, you know, we used to go play basketball like every day.
Yep.
It was like you go from house to hoop, mm-hmm. all day long. So there was, you know, one or two little girls in the neighborhood. So it was after one of those long day hooping sessions. So, you know, I think the guy that was with me was trying to run a little game on the girl or whatever. Mm. And so we were out there talking and we walked her home because it was late. It was dark, you know, late for 14, 15 year olds at that time. So we walked her home and we walking back a block away from our, like you could hop the fence and be in our backyard. So close, and blue lights in the neighborhood. He's, what are y'all doing? Where are you going? Where's your ID? I'm like, I'm 15 years old. I have a student ID at home when I go to school. I don't have an ID. And the guy that was with me had like a fork in his pocket to get in his house. So they up there searching us, and he was like, talking all kind of shit. I mean, I don't remember. It's been 15, 20 plus years. Mm-hmm. But long and short is he basically was like, and I remember this part vividly, is when he said, all right, when we tell you to get off this car, your black ass is better run as fast as you can or we will shoot you.
No shit.
First ever interaction with a police officer and they threatened to shoot me. So how in the hell do you expect somebody to approach life going forward? I mean, what do you expect the kid to do?
You can't trust him after that.
Right. So life goes on. And yes, I've had some asshole cops. I had a cool ass cop in Mississippi pull me over. That shit was hilarious. But I mean, there's really good ones. And there's also really, really bad ones. And then there's some that are kind of in between that go along with the flow. And that's the scary part, is that you get those that are just like, okay, well, you know, if I try to say something, it works against me. So I'm just going to shut my mouth because I got a family to feed. And I get that. And but even still, the shit is wrong. And what's crazy about it all is it's like when you explain it to people, especially those that are like, how do I put this? Never seen black people or haven't been around a lot of black people.
I met a couple of guys like that.
It doesn't compute. And they're just like, well, I don't understand. I mean, if you're just doing what the officer tells you to do, there shouldn't be a problem. Like you hear now, if you just comply, it's not always that simple. And that's the part that people don't understand, is that you can do everything right and you can sneeze. And because he's a scary ass already, or she, I mean,
yeah,
not discrimination, right? You in some shit. I mean, you hear unarmed, you know, in the back, running away. I mean, it's just crazy. And it's not just as simple as, you know, let's pass some laws, let's hold hands and sing Kumbaya, let's take them to the African American Museum, let's have a cultural expert come in and explain how special black people really are, and it's actually okay to be friends with them and not to be scared of a black man that's walking down the street with not a damn thing in his hand. So it's some systemic things, and it's in some of the training, and it's just some crazy shit, and it's unfortunate. It's scary. And the biggest thing for me is when I explain it to my kids and they have to ask me why, that shit's gonna be heavy, because I don't really have an answer for them. It's
and we
the
don't.
Way it is.
We don't. And our answers are based off of our feelings and our experiences. Yeah. There's no real like fact check you can really give them for this situation. But shout out to the New Jersey police out there. I was reading that today, actually. For the whole year 2020, they had zero police shootings in New Jersey, and that was due to their, I think it was de-escalation training or something.
Sure.
Some extra training step that New Jersey has taken, and they haven't had any shooting deaths involving a cop for the whole year. So that's a big one. Training, and accountability. Don't just give these motherfuckers 2 weeks leave with pay and all that other shit. No, you I don't want to say that because that sounds weird, but you crush them, man. You crush them.
Right. I mean, that's the thing. I mean, I equated it to when I was explaining it to somebody a while ago. It's kind of like, think about it in class back when you were in school, like middle school, high school, like that. And, you know, some of those teachers that you had, they didn't play. So even the baddest kids in school didn't mess with those teachers.
Miss Stokes.
Yes, goodness.
Not a game being played with that later.
But you had those teachers that you knew. You was a pushovers. They couldn't discipline. They couldn't control their class. So you would have those main kids that would act up in class. And then other kids would see like, oh, well, shit. Kevin getting away with it. So why can't I do this shit too? Let me throw something real quick. So I think that's part of it too, is that like you were saying, if there's no accountability or no nothing for your actions, if you're going to tell me I get desk duty for a couple months while an investigation is on, then it's business as usual. I mean, okay. If you really thinking like, what's the worst that's going to really happen? So it's that, it's cultural too. I mean, it's things that have to be learned, and it's just some things that you just can't fix in 2 years, 4 years, 3 years, 5 years, because it took generations to get to a scenario like this. And that's the thing that people just don't really want to talk about. And I find that a lot of times people work in absolutes. Like you hear, what is it, ACAB, all cops are bad. Mm-hmm. No, they're not. No, they're not. All cops are racist. No, they're not. They are not. Are there some assholes? Yes. Are there some racist cops? Yes. Yep.
And I want asshole even... cops is right. across the board. Got them right. some black asshole cops, mm-hmm. some Hispanic asshole cops. Yeah, sometimes you can just watch cops and you'll catch at least one asshole.
And for those folks that check this out that, you know, don't understand, haven't experienced it, when someone's explaining that this is what's happening to them, don't try to place your experiences on theirs and be like, well, are you sure it was really that bad? Mm-mm. Because if you do, you're creating a situation where that's that piece of deniability where people won't believe your story, mm-hmm. and where they're like, oh, we're gonna always believe the cop and everything they say. And again, that accountability thing, mm-hmm. I mean, it's just craziness. I mean, it's just like, I mean, I don't want to talk about current events and stuff too much or recent events, but this one happened, like when the cop here in DFW went in my man's house off duty and shot him.
Yeah, I heard about that.
What the hell? How do you justify that? How do you explain that? And yes, she got charged, sort of. But how do you explain that?
Yeah, she got charged with manslaughter or some shit, right?
Yeah, she got, like, something. But how do you explain that to a kid that's watching, you know, you're sitting in your house chilling, living your life, and you get shot? How do you explain that? And I always wondered in that story is if, what if it was like one of our houses?
I'm going to treat that as like a fucking...
but that's my point.
A goddamn burglar.
That's my point. What happens when that happens?
And it has. I can't remember where, when, or how, but I remember this one dude, Melanin guy. Mm-hmm. They did the same thing. They broke in his house, but he shot the cops.
Well, that's what Breonna Taylor's boyfriend did.
They didn't get him at all.
Yeah.
He shot them. He got arrested, but they found the cops was wrong. He got off. And honestly, that's how it's supposed to be. I mean, mm-hmm. if you got a warrant or something like that, or just cause, do what you got to do. But they're supposed to still knock or at least announce mm-hmm. themselves before they just come up in the house. Because I'm telling you, you just boom. You're going to get a boom, all right.
In kind.
It's gonna be like that one video. I'm gonna blow your ass right back out that window. And that's all I'm gonna say.